Facial structure is something that can be modified. Mm. You'll see these people, they're mouth breathers. Now there's the jawsercizer is really big in Hollywood. These like things where like...
Bouncy mouthpiece.
Yeah. A lot of people who are really overweight or even mildly overweight who have sleep apnea have more anxiety because they're not getting rid of CO2.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So they're literally suffocating in sleep and you'll see these people, they're mouth breathers. Not even necessarily just people who are overweight. So it's not good to be a mouth breather. You don't blow off enough CO2, anxiety goes up.
Yeah, I've heard you should sleep with like athletic tape on your mouth so you train yourself to breathe through your nose because apparently it's way better for you.
Yeah, I'll do cardio. I do a long run once a week or some long cardio. I do it with, I try not mouth breathe the whole time.
Can it also change face shape?
Yeah, so there's a wild book called Jaws, A Hidden Epidemic by colleagues of mine at Stanford. And they have these twin studies. One kid grows up in a culture where they eat a lot of soft food, drinking Capri Sun, eating applesauce, baby food. The other one is, you know, got stuck in the jungle or wherever it is, and they're chewing on bones and chewing their food. And one kid, these are identical twins, has beautiful jaw structure and high cheekbones, and the eyes look nice and clear. The other kid is like droopy. The teeth are there in their mouth breathing. They show this, there's one case of this young girl who just, she got a pet hamster, I think it was, got an allergy to the hamster, and literally took this beautiful young girl and her face just starts aging at a rapid rate. They get rid of the hamster. She goes back to nasal breathing. They do a little of encouragement of nasal breathing using the mouth closure thing at night, do a little bit of medical tape. And like her, these beautiful, almost like model-esque features come back in this girl. Jaw shape and the clear to the nasal passages. You know, really there's no reason why any of us should ever had braces, but all your teeth should fit in your mouth, right? And you should be able to put your tongue on the roof of your mouth with your mouth closed. I can't quite do it. Your palate should be somewhat wide, you know? And so when we see, now there's the jawsercizer is really big in Hollywood. That and peptides are like taking over.
Wait, jawsercizer?
Yeah, these like things where like.
Bouncy mouthpiece.
Yeah. The only problem is it makes people drool. It's pretty gross. But you know, it's
work.
Exercise, they definitely work. They change your facial structure. They dilate the nasal passages. You look at somebody who keeps their facial muscles strong. And this is for women and men, their jaw muscles strong. We're not talking about the like, you know, like, I mean, there's certain people who are like genetic freaks, like my friend Laird Hamilton. He's got, you know, it's like big old neck and like huge jaw. Like he looks like a, you know, an actor from the 70s or something. He's just naturally that way. But people who care about their facial structure, especially who don't want, a lot of people are concerned, like, what's going on with my skin? A lot of women and men are like putting all the stuff on it to figure out how to get rid of the droopy eyes. It's actually a facial muscle issue. And were they just to do some jaw exercises and focus on not mouth breathing, it completely changes the structure of the face in just 2-3 months.
And there's like skincare salons called like Face Gym and other places where they're literally giving your face a workout. And you'll notice that it's like a lymphatic type of massage. It'll change after one session. So I imagine just doing the training.
Yeah. So when girls are getting like, maybe this doesn't work actually, when girls are getting filler to like put in, like they have the hollow space or whatever here or here, does that?
Well, I look at the plastic surgery thing now and it's kind of crazy. I mean, maybe this just reflects my age and my generation, but I see some people with wearing so much dark eye makeup, plus they're getting the cheekbone inserts. They look like skeletons. Now that's not, listen, everyone's got their taste, especially if they're really lean, you know, but facial structure is something that can be modified. And so chewing your food, chewing hard foods is something we used to do a lot more. All this slurping down of food and calories we know isn't good from the obesity side, but it's also not good from the jaw structure, teeth structure, face structure. And it's all related, you know? So that book Jaws is amazing. People can just look it up online if they don't want to buy the book. Just do, Jaws, mouth structure, face structure, and then just go images and you'll see these pictures. And this was known in the 1800s. There was a book called Shut Your Mouth by a British doctor who talked about the fact that people who snore, sleep like this, and then during the daytime, they become mouth breathers. He said they become less attractive than the people who are nose breathers. Yeah, it's pretty interesting.
Fuck.
Yeah, it's really interesting. And this is like a zero cost thing, but it's not emphasized enough.
At all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not emphasized. I've heard this about is crazy. This.
Crazy.
Yeah. I saw random things on like maybe TikTok or Instagram of people who said, yeah, I started chewing this thing, or maybe it was
the hard gum.
I thought, yeah, there was a hard gum.
Yeah.
And I thought that this was some, like, just some ploy, some, like, gimmick.
Some TikTok trend.
Yeah, to get some quick money out of people. But no, this is legit. Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, and there's a, also for avoiding orthodontia, kids who chew hard foods, who have to chew their food, eating real food and chewing their food, not just peanut butter, slurping down food all the time. They, using their jaw and their teeth, they have really nice teeth. In fact, the argument was made, and there's a, animals in the animal kingdom have beautiful teeth structure. You don't see the messed up teeth. They have beautiful teeth structure, and they don't wear braces, but they're tearing flesh and they're doing their thing.
We brought this up before. If you look at, like, mummified people from like way back in the day, their teeth are always like pretty good.
Yeah.
And, like, they're not, they don't have all crazy, they're not eating sugar at the same rate, stuff like that.
But those are the elites, bro. what I mean? Only the elites got mummified.
Chewing on bones and things like that. Well, and if people think this sounds like kind of like.
Actually, wait, that makes sense. They were probably the ones eating the best food.
Yes.
The ones having to chew on meat because it was the rich people that are going to be able to get that meat.
Because
I don't think they were mummifying everybody, right?
But I mean, like, people like the bog man that, like, is in, England that got frozen in, like, some bog.
Oh, okay. Even,
like,
he has.
Yeah, their teeth are not in the way the Americans' teeth are now.
So then why did humans start losing their teeth? Is it like
this nice structure, you mean?
Yeah, like, you even look back at, old presidents and stuff like that. Like, George Washington had all fake teeth. Like, what did he start ingesting that's getting rid of?
Well, I think back then the problem was that, there was no, dental care is still a good idea.
Yeah.
In fact, bacteria in the teeth and not, I'm terrible
maybe
about
sugar,
flossing.
Maybe sugar too?
Sugar and also people not flossing. I mean, flossing and, flossing and tooth care actually improves heart health. This is not pseudoscience.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Because if you have bacteria living in your mouth, right, and starting to take residence in your mouth and they get into your system, it can cause issues for the rest of your body.
Mm.
I mean, we, of course, operate as a whole system. I'm pretty bad about flossing. I was one of these kids that had tons of cavities. It was just, and I took decent, I brush twice a day. I don't know, are any of you three times a day brushers? You
get those people. I try to be, but I can't do it.
People, they always impress me. They're brushing their teeth after lunch. Yeah, it's not me either. Flossing and brushing, definitely good to keep bacteria out. But it's amazing what chewing your food really well
Yeah.
will do for a facial structure.